Child of God, do not worry about tomorrow. A lot of people sometimes are eager to see the future, saying, if only I know the future, perhaps I'll do things differently. But in reality, my friend, the future is not ours to know all of it. It is in the hands of God, whatever it may bring. Remember, my friend, the things that are revealed, they are for us. But the things that are not revealed, they are for God. God, my friend, isn't merciless. Even though He does not allow you to see the future, He also gives you assurance that the future will be bright and full of hope. So that even while we are having so many struggles in life today, we can be rest assured that the future will come good for the benefit of all who believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my friend, do not worry about tomorrow for any reasons, for tomorrow will worry about itself. Each day has enough trouble of its own, and that is according to Matthew, the 6th chapter, the 34th verse. God, my friend, has a plan for us in the future, and He knows all about it. He will prosper us. He will give us security and hope for a good future. But the plans of God for His people depend on how they will live their lives and how they will trust Him. Therefore, my friend, call upon the Lord. Come to the Lord. Live normally in the midst of difficulties, according to Jeremiah, the 29th chapter, the 4th verse. God promised that He will come and fulfill His gracious promises to you. He will restore all of His people. He will put an end to their sufferings. Trust in the Lord, for He is faithful. Restrain from weeping, according to Jeremiah, the 31st chapter, the 15th verse. Have hope, my friend, for the future. The days are coming. The time is coming when everything is going to reveal itself, and you would see that God never left you. The Lord, my friend, is busy right now doing His works for the good of His people. And that, my friend, includes you. The days are coming, and the only hope we have is with Jesus Christ. Our future depends on it, beloved. Sometimes we worry about so many things that are not in our power to control, but God's. We struggle, we sorrow, we have sleepless nights about these things which God has ordained for Himself, for His own glory and honor. We try to take up the responsibilities of God. Beloved, no matter how hard you try or push it, what is for God is for God. It is only God who has the power and the choice to release or hold on to the things that He has put in His own power. In fact, even Jesus said on one occasion that there are things that are not for the knowing of every other person, but only God has reserved it in His own power. Sometimes we are afraid of what we will go through without the knowledge or answers or physical manifestations, but God has kept these things in His power. And that is why the Christian faith, the Christian walk, it's actually a walk of faith. Beloved, my question to you is, do you really trust God? If you do and can rely on Him without any hustle, then why the worry? And why do you complain? Some things are not meant for you to know. We just have to have faith in God Almighty and leave it all to Him. Have hope, my friend, in the future and prepare for it every day. As a child of God, a Christian for that matter, you, my friend, have power resident within you to take on every challenge that will come your way in the future. From the day the Holy Spirit came upon you, you have been endued with power to go out there and preach the gospel, to heal the sick, and many more. Beloved, why fear when you have power to rebuke that fear? Why worry when you have the power to commit everything into the hands of God? Hear this, child of God. You have what it takes to declare in the name of Jesus and see the physical manifestation of what you have declared. So, why do you fear? Why are you afraid? Hear this, child of God. You have to allow God to be God and allow yourself to be a man or a woman, a man of faith and a woman of faith. You have the power. Use it. What's not within your power, allow God to handle it, for He will never leave you to shame or destruction, but will bring you to an end that will glorify Him. It is all about Jesus and no one else. Just focus on Him and allow the precious Holy Spirit to occupy you and lead you in all things. He has said in His Word that He will never leave you. He says, I'll never leave you nor forsake you, says the Lord. This is what the Apostle Paul came to understand. And so he said, for I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate you from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Beloved, you have to understand that until you get to heaven, trials, temptations, hardships, persecutions are inevitable. Knowing that you will encounter these every day, wake up, not dwelling on it, rather to focus on heaven. Focus on God, where you will spend your eternity. One day at a time, my friend, try to enjoy the blessing of each and every new day that God gives to you. Do not let the worries of tomorrow steal the joy of today. Instead, my friend, of complaining about what you don't have, thank God for what you do have. The privilege to be among the living, the health that He has given you, the family that you have, the life that you have. Jesus, for example, while preaching and understanding the situation at that time, said to the crowd during the Sermon on the Mount, therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about itself. Sufficient for the day is its own trouble. And that is according to Matthew, the 6th chapter, the 36th verse. Therefore, I say to you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, nor about your body, what you will put on. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the air, for they neither sow nor reap, nor do they gather into barns. Yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they are? Which of you, by worrying, can add one cubit to his stature? That's in Matthew, the 6th chapter, from the 25th to the 27th verse. Hear this, child of God. When you start realizing that this world is not your home, nothing will mean anything to you any longer, because you will know that you are on a journey. While you are on this journey, keep pushing, my friend. Keep enduring. And most importantly, cast all your burdens onto Jesus, for He cares for you. It is written, in fact, do not fear any of those things which you are about to suffer. Indeed, the devil is about to throw some of you into prison, that you may be tested, and you will have tribulations. But be faithful unto death, and I will give you the crown of life. Beloved, what are you worrying about today? Give it to God. He's waiting for you. Imagine your worry as a ball, and just throw this ball to God for Him to deal with. In 1 Peter, the 5th chapter, the 7th verse, it says, cast all your anxiety on Him, because He cares for you. Sometimes, my friend, you have to throw your worries to Him just once. Sometimes you have to do that several times in a day. But He always will give you His peace in exchange, and you, my friend, will see His glory in your life. Free of worries, free of fears, free of complaints, and free of anxieties. God is waiting for you. Give it all to Him. May God, my friend, bless you.